There are some circumstances where wearing a face covering may be marginally beneficial as a precautionary measure. The evidence suggests that wearing a face covering does not protect you, but it may protect others if you are infected but have not developed the symptoms. However, workers and visitors who want to wear a face covering should be allowed to do so. A face covering can be very simple and may be worn in enclosed spaces where social distancing isn't possible. It just needs to cover your mouth and your nose. It's not the same as a face mask, such as the surgical masks or respirators used by health and care workers. Similarly, face coverings are not the same as the PPE used to manage risks like dust and spray in an industrial context. Supplies of PPE, including face masks, must continue to be reserved for those who need them to protect against risks in their workplace, such as health and care workers, and those in industrial settings, like those exposed to dust hazards. It's important to know that the evidence of the benefit of using face coverings to protect others is weak, and the effect is likely to be small. Therefore, face coverings are not a replacement for other ways of managing risk, including minimizing the time spent in contact, using fixed teams and partnering for work close up, and increasing the hand and sanitizing and surface washing. These other measures remain the best way of managing risks in the workplace, and the government would therefore not expect to see employees relying on face coverings as a risk management for the purpose of their health and safety assessments. Wearing a face covering is required by law when travelling as a passenger on public transport in England. Some people don't have to wear a face covering for health, age, or equality reasons. Elsewhere in England, it's optional and is not required by law, including in the workplace. If you choose to wear one, it's important to use a face covering properly and wash your hands before putting them on and before and after taking them off. Employers should support their workers in using face coverings safely if they choose to wear one. This means telling workers to wash their hands thoroughly with soap and water for 20 seconds or use hand sanitizer before putting a face covering on and before and after removing it. When wearing a face covering, you should avoid touching your face or face covering as it could contaminate them with germs from your hands. Change your face covering if it becomes damp or if you've touched it. Continue to wash your hands regularly and change and wash your face covering daily. If the material is washable, wash in line with the manufacturer's instructions. If it's not washable, dispose of it carefully in your usual waste and still practice social distancing where possible. Finally, you can make face coverings at home, and you can find guidance on how to use them and make them safely on the government website gov.uk.